Football.
Good.
Is back. Despite extensive damage from both Hurricanes Laura and Delta, the St. Louis Catholic High School Saints have returned to the field, ready to play.
Playing football, you know, is a sense of normalcy for us all because we get to interact with each other and not have to worry about any, like, rules or stuff like that. So it's just good to be back playing with boys.
A welcome distraction, though football was one of the only sports capable of practicing on campus. Other sports like basketball and volleyball weren't as fortunate.
Here, most of the damage is along the upper windows and walls.
Basically, after Hurricane Laura, there were two usable spaces on our campus. Our two gyms, we have an older gym that's a historical landmark here on campus. It was damaged, the roof had significant roof damage, water leaked all over the place, and the floor is pretty badly warped.
Returning to sports, however, was never a question.
These kids need to go to school, they need to play ball. We need to sit in the stands and yell at the refs. It's just part of being a human nowadays.
For Brooks Habits, a sophomore tight end at St. Louis, the return to football has meant more to him than most.
Just being a kid, you know, just having fun and not worrying about anything else, just forgetting about what's at my house right now.
And even with football practice back in full swing amid the recovery effort, Brooks still reflects on how much he lost to Hurricane Laura.
When me and my dad got back to our house, it was just emotional because it was just gone.
Brooks arrived to his house the day after Hurricane Laura to find it destroyed. Pieces of roof scattered across the yard, their possessions blown around the neighborhood, and an unfixable hole for Brooks and his family.
It still, to this day, you know, it's kind of hard just to wrap your head around it all. You know, that was my house, and I was basically raised in that, so it's just heartbreaking.
And as the oldest of three, Brooks has taken the burden in helping his father in the cleanup process, committing to long days and early mornings, all while still being 15 years old.
Kids were doing grown-up stuff. They were tarping roofs. They were ripping out sheetrock. Just to take that 2 hours and be a high school kid practicing football meant so much to them.
And though through tragedy, Brooks's family and the entire community of Lake Charles has only grown stronger.
Yeah, we've been hit by two hurricanes, but people here don't really wait around for somebody to hand them something. People here have banded together and helped their neighbors and helped their families and started the rebuild process on their own.
When me and my dad pulled up to our house the day after, my dad called my uncle that we were staying at, and he basically just said on the phone, "We need help." And probably an hour and a half after, they were there with probably like three trucks, trailers, everything, and they were just helping us move stuff out. That was probably the biggest, like, family moment for me.
The power of football is strong in the wake of a devastation. The power of people, however, is unmatched. Victor Prieto, WUFT News.